Thanks, Dennis, very much.
Well, I have the pleasure and the privilege of introducing Victor tonight. And I think it's actually a really auspicious occasion to do it because of something that happened quite a distance from here, and that was in Canberra. And that was the National Apology to the Aborigines. And you may say to me, why is that relevant to an exhibition about Israel? The reason that it's relevant is actually not so much about Israel in a direct sense, but certainly about Victor in a very, very personal way. For those of you who don't know, Victor was the head of painting at the Victorian College of the Arts. It's a very distinguished position, and something that he did with great aplomb, and I think there are many artists working today who owe a great deal to Victor. And one of the things that Victor did for many, many years was to take his students out to country, indigenous country of Australia. And much of Victor's work has been informed by that. Those of you who know the Australian Haggadah, which is an extraordinary document, will have seen in it many of the motives and the inspirations that came from Aboriginal Australia. So even though we're not talking directly about Israel, I think that what Victor has done and where he's come from and the relationships that he sees between the land here and the land in Israel owes a lot to what he did as an artist and as an educator. Even today, looking at the works around me, I think you can see his sensibility to the land. And the other interesting thing is that Victor is a landscape artist, and he's actually one of the very few landscape artists to paint Israel. Israel doesn't have a great tradition of landscape art, and it's taken another person, the other, to actually do it and to create something in that environment which has been so powerful. And those of you who saw the Negev exhibition, and those of you who are privileged enough to buy something from the Negev exhibition, will know that you have an extraordinary piece of work from a person who has great intellect, great sensitivity, great emotion about the land. Victor has done a great deal. I'm not going to go into detail about what he's done. It's in the Jewish News, and you'll see it in the catalogue. Other than to say that I think tonight we're very privileged to be here, to be able to witness this, and also on a day that probably none of us will ever experience again.
Yiddish word of the week.
Yeah, quick snatch.
Okay, Yiddish word of the week
is musikant.
Musician. Isn't it an interesting word? Musikant.
Musikant.
Not in the offensive way. It's because, like, so many Jewish kids who learn music aren't good at it. And they can't. They're just musikant. And that's probably where it came from historically. I think Moshe Rabbeinu, I think Moses, way back, he said, you know what, go on a mountain and sing, but get out of my face, I can't listen to you.
Did he actually say climb every mountain?
He might have.
That's where it came from.
Definitely.
It's the sound of Moses.
The hills are alive.
Musikant. And the other one is Entschuldig, which is sorry for everything.
Not really sorry.
It's actually excuse me.
It's excuse me.
Because
we don't have a word. In Yiddish, there is no word.
As we've mentioned before, we just can't say sorry.
And if somebody asks us to say sorry, we say, excuse me.
You want me to say sorry?
And that's how it's coming.
Entschuldig me really means get out of my face.
It's exactly right. It's sorry.
Yeah. Like this. I've got style. I got my girl. Who can ask for anything more?
Now you can see why we're sorry.
That was a goodbye.
Woo! On this basis, we're sorry to go out this way, but we are going.
It's piano.
Until next week.
This mess that we created, that you started.